Welcome to Developing Bangladesh, your knowledge partner on trade, investment, personnel, entrepreneurship, and economic development. Please subscribe to Developing Bangladesh now.
We don't need such a big administration or bureaucracy. We should focus to reduce this bureaucracy. Instead of reducing, we are increasing the size, volume. So that is also another reason for increasing the administrative cost in the budget. There are many negative points. There are, I have told you some of the positive points.
Sir, thank you very much. Dear audience, actually, sir is going to give us a synopsis of the overall budget. But budget is a huge document. So there are some positive things, there are some negative things, but we should be rational in terms of few issues. For example, as it is self-contradictory that government is raising the threshold, exemption threshold from the income tax. But at the same time, he is again in the same document, same speech, the finance minister is saying that if you would like to get these government services, you have to pay 2,500 taka annual tax. So where is the exemption? What about the exempted people? So this is number one. It is a self-contradiction here in this document. Secondly, sir has rightly pointed out that tax exemption, there are some sectors. Obviously, it should be. There would be some sectors who will enjoy import duty exemption for as a their safeguard or promotional matters. But how this sector will be selected? Which sector will be selected? If it is selected, then what about the equal treatment? For example, it is must discuss that if ready-made garments can enjoy XYZ benefits, then other export-oriented sectors like pharmaceuticals, leather, jute and jute goods, agro-processing products, those who are also earning foreign currency, they should be treated equally. So if any of these sectors are inside the duty exemption, but other is outside the duty exemption, that equal treatment will be hampered. It is rightly pointed out, sir. Then social safety net, education and healthcare, these are very important sectors. Very important sector. We see in this budget, proposed budget, percentage of budget, these are being neglected. So why? Because healthcare, till now pandemic is just behind us. It is beside us. So we just learned many things during the pandemic. So why this healthcare sector again going back? Universal pension scheme is a praiseworthy initiative, but the initiative should be taken considering all segments of the social classes, not only targeting a particular sectors for the public servant, for the ready-made garment workers, for others. It should be universal, Finally, again, another question that is public service. Nowadays, government tried to implement digital Bangladesh. Most of the services could be provided virtually, but why these services are not being digitalized till now? There are many services which could be provided digitally, but due to some unknown reason, these services are not fully automated. Why these are not happening? It is a matter of question. If we can provide these services virtually, then why the total cost, the expenditure of public administration is going up? So it is contradictory. If any person would like to physically visit to provide any service, then it is costlier than virtual service providing. So either we should go for digital Bangladesh, smart Bangladesh, this side, it will reduce our administrative cost. Otherwise, we should think of increasing the administrative cost. So it deserves government explanation, proper explanation why it is going up, or digital Bangladesh is going to be stopped, we are going back again. So this sort of administration, sir, at this point of time, we would like to listen from you about the business benefit. Let's start with the startup. What benefit you can identify from this proposed budget for the startups?
I didn't find anything exactly specifically for the startup, even for the SMEs.
So it's a question
because the inequality is increasing day by day. Every year we see that during the pandemic many SMEs has been shut down, and if there is no new entry of a startup or new entrepreneurs come up, so the opportunity of entering new entrepreneurs in the market is very, very minimum, because there is no support, no technical support, no administrative support, no financial support. At least there are many in documents, but if you practically go to the market, you will see that there is nobody to support them. Even banks are so rigid. They don't want to give loan to the SMEs. They try to avoid. They are running after the big group of companies to give in a single stroke few thousand crore taka, few hundred crore taka to a company. But they are not willing to give even 1 crore or 50 lakhs taka to a SME. So you say, it's the mindset of the bankers and policymakers that in seminar they speak very nicely. They talk in favor of entrepreneurs and SMEs, but when they go to the office, actually they forget it. There is nothing for them.
Sir, thank you very much. It is a very short but precise answer that I cannot identify anything for the startups, also including the SMEs. In the previous budget, we saw government raise the trade license fee as well as trade license renewal fee. They are trying to bring more entrepreneurs into formal sector. But in this budget, we have not observed any types of revision of that particular increases of trade license, number one. Second one is the brokers, the middlemen, inside the administration, their government is charging, for example, 3 taka. They are imposing 7 taka, so trade license fee is becoming 10 taka. So government obviously knows it, but they don't recognize, as well as they don't have any revision for this particular segment. I mean the small firms, the medium one, the startups. So you have rightly pointed out, in the seminar, symposium, or public forum, we are listening many good things, many positive things. But in the budget, what type of reflection could be there? Over to you, sir.
Exactly. Because government has given subsidy for the public sector, nationalized industries, around 20,000 crore. To make up the loss of this private public sector industries or services. So why don't they allocate 5,000 crore taka for the SMEs so that they can give collateral free credit loan to these SMEs? That they never consider. And there are something I forget to mention that this year, government is, there are some rapid change in policies. That's for the fuel and utilities, they are going to make it not fixed, but according to market and global price, the petrol and gas prices and others. So it has an opportunity and also challenge. I don't know how the government is going to do, because primarily possibly they will fix the petrol price on monthly basis, considering the average price. I don't know, not yet. There is no policy declared. And many of the subsidies, they are going to withdraw, because all these sector corporations, they are exempted from the paying the income tax. Now, there will be no discount, no exemption for them. The sector corporation will give income tax. And also, corporation for import of fuel, gas and others, electricity government is giving subsidy. They have started phasing out this subsidy. This will increase the cost of the service. The fixed income people are going to pay more from their fixed income. That is another challenge for the really fixed income people or lower income people. So it is a major policy decision government has. Again, another good option of carbon tax introduced in this budget. If somebody
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe now.